Hey, this is Jonas from PVcase, and today we are going to have a look at how to use AutoCAD for beginners. There are plenty of first-time AutoCAD users that transition to AutoCAD just to use PVcase. This may be daunting at first, so we're going to have a look at this together and see how you can get started with ease. Let's dive in. One of the first things you want to do and be aware of how to do is how to move. So, you can simply press in your middle mouse button and use your cursor to move around. You can use the scroll wheel to zoom in and out. And if you hold down shift while pressing down the middle mouse button and move your cursor around, you can pivot around the screen and adjust not only to a top-down view, but to an isometric view. Switching views can also be done here by clicking here and choosing whether you want top, bottom, or one of the isometric views that is available to you. I'll switch back to top. Then the first thing you would want to be aware of is how to create basic shapes. We will start with a polyline. Creating a polyline is simple. You can type keyline and press enter. You then specify either the coordinate where you want to start your point, your polyline from, or simply place it wherever you deem fit. In this case, I place it adjacent to the road and follow it here, drawing a perimeter around this plot of land and pressing enter once I have completed my polyline. If you want to create rectangles, circles, these are all accessible through specialty commands, which we will have linked down below from the Autodesk Help Center, or you can go to the home screen and find all these basic tools accessible here. One of the tools I personally find to be invaluable is the Properties menu. As you can see, I have had it open this entire time. You can launch it by typing Properties and pressing Enter on the keyboard. This will allow you to see properties of any object you have selected. So in this case, I'll select one of my elevation points for the point data cloud. And here we can see which layer it is, the color, the line type and thickness, as well as the geometry coordinates, which in this case correlate to the local coordinate system for this drawing. Another tool that is very useful is Explode, which can be used to take complex objects and reduce them to a baser form. So for example, we have this polyline that we drew in an earlier stage. To reduce it to simple lines, you can use the Explode menu and select the object, press enter, and now we can see that the object has been reduced to four polylines instead of a singular polyline. Another thing to be aware of that some of the functions of AutoCAD can have submenus in the creation process. For example, if we type rectangle and we look below, we can see the text dialog menu, which has several options where we can enter a chamfer, elevation, fillet, thickness, and width, which if you weren't looking at initially, could have been missed. So we can click on chamfer and enter a parameter here, for example, 5. And now if we draw a rectangle, instead of it having right quarters, we can have a chamfer applied to it. These are some of the many features that AutoCAD has on offer. Being aware of them, knowing when and how to use them, can greatly expedite the design process. I want to thank you for joining me, and I'll see you next time. Bye.